Good evening, everybody. How's everybody doing? Okay. This meeting has a heartbeat. This meeting has got a soul. This meeting has got meaning. We have watched the radical left take over in our city and our country. The fact that the president has taken a 180 on Israel is unforgivable. Tonight we're honored, and I mean honored, to have a very good friend of mine and a very good friend of this club's and a very good friend to humanity on a whole and to the city of New York on a whole in Dove Hikind. Dove has been a fighter for the cause that nobody really wanted. But we'll all remember where we were that October 7th morning. You know, there was a song that was put out when September 11th happened. And we said, "Where were you that September morn?" It's a great song. Alan Jackson, exactly. We all know where we were on the morning of October 7th, when I'll speak for myself and I'm sure the crowd, when I say our hearts fell out, our stomachs fell out. Yeah. I was in the kitchen, I put on the TV as I always do, and I just couldn't believe the horror. It was that in my face that second. And it was when the girl got dragged out of the car, all bloodied. And they dragged her by her hair. And then her pants were bleached with blood. Covered in blood. And then they took her and they threw her in the backseat of the car like she was an animal. The fury that came over me, I can't even explain. I was furious. I was upset, visibly upset. That I was screaming, "I can't believe it. What the hell is going on?" I didn't understand. I truly did not. On what was going on in Israel. The brutality. Everything was so raw and in your face. And these people were getting away with it. How is this possible? Coming from where I come from, I would have said just flatten it. Just flatten it. On September the 11th, I wanted those jets in the air by midnight that night. I didn't want to wait for the UN to tell us how we're supposed to act. I didn't want permission from a left-sided government to tell us what we should do. No, we act. We act. An act of violence like that is retaliated, and it's retaliated hard. And when I was asked, I got right on this, I just could not. I just threw my whole self into what was going on in Israel. And a lot of you know, I was asked to speak on a lot of different occasions on TV and such, because what's really very sad is when you exist in the world that we are all existing in, we find ourselves shaking our heads and saying, "I don't understand. I just don't get it. I don't understand." Please stop saying you don't understand. It's a reality. It's happening. We say it in my office all the time pertaining to other things. What's going on? I don't understand. What do you mean you don't understand? It is what it is, and it needs to be dealt with. And this is what we have to do now. We can no longer, and will no longer tolerate the radical left-wing Democrats or progressives or whatever they choose to call themselves. It is totally unacceptable to me when I have someone like Calvin Yeager come into the MLO's office and say, how come the only person in here, the little one with the gray hair, has got on an Israeli and an American pin? Why is it only the woman whose name ends in a vowel that's got any guts to say anything? The reply is simple. You take a knee now, you take a knee now, we are done. We are done. This is our time. Our time is now. Nobody wants violence. Nobody's preaching violence. What we are saying is we've had enough and we're not taking it anymore. We see the Palestinian and the Hamas protesters taking over our streets. This was just, I could not even believe them marching tens of thousands, or thousands and thousands, I should say, not to exaggerate, over the Brooklyn Bridge, taking over Lower Manhattan. Seriously? Really? We got an anti-Semite in our council. We've got several, but we've got one in particular who makes no bones about it. And she asked to see me when I said what I said on Twitter. Say that to my face, Vicky. Really now? Well, maybe she doesn't know exactly who she's talking to. The point is this. When you bring home and you set free the hostages, that's when we will stop. We will not stop before that. We will not take a knee. I will not take a knee. We will not take a knee. People like Doug and myself, you do not see enough of this. I am happy to say that I am raising them to be this way. Because this is the only way people feel that they're not alone. You know that you're not alone. Because, like I said to you before, if we don't stand up now, we will be on our knees until they bleed and they will love it. Do not allow that to happen. We have Dove Hikind with us tonight. And to have Dove here, he's a humanitarian. He's been back and forth to Israel, I don't know how many times. All in the name of humanitarianism. And I couldn't be more pleased. So on right now, and he changed his party from Democrat to Republican. Now, mind you, I never want to make this a D and an R thing. Keep this in mind, because you all know me well enough. I do not want to make this a D or an R thing. Unfortunately, it has become that. And you know what? When I, in all due respect, and I say this with all due respect, for every Jew that's in this room, if you do not vote properly in November, there's a big problem here.
Yep.
And I don't care if you've never voted Republican in your life before, if you make that mistake in November, we will reap what you have sown, because you outnumber us by 10 to 1 or more than that. So with this, I'm going to give the mic over to Dove. It's all yours, Dove. Take it away.
I just want to mention one name before I start. because we know each other, and in 2024, Republicans need to win everywhere. On every single, on every single level. And the person I want to recognize who came this close and probably won is Tom Sullivan. And I think when I endorsed you, I was still a Democrat, because that never mattered to me. It was about the person. Now, I have to say, we're living at a time when there's very little leadership. I'm not talking about people with titles. There are a lot of people with titles, but there are very few people who are leaders. There are even fewer people who have courage of their convictions to do the right thing. And I gotta tell you, a true superstar, someone who is, I can tell you that God loves her 100%. And that is Vicky Paladino. She's the real thing. She's the real thing. She really is. I love her. And I admire her for who she is. Ladies and gentlemen, a couple of days after October 7th, I remember that day and will never forget it, as you will never forget. I was in our synagogue. My rabbi walked in. You could look at his face and something was terribly, terribly wrong. And he told us there was an attack on Israel and 40 people had been murdered, 40. And of course you can imagine, 40 Jews murdered. And we all know what the results were. And just a couple of days after October 7th, I said to my wife, I need to do something. You know, I can shed a tear. I can talk to my friends. I can do a video, but I need to do something more. I'm not going to solve the problems of the world. I'm not going to change certain realities, but I need to do something more. And within literally 2 days, I got on a plane with some people from my team, from Americans Against Anti-Semitism, and we headed to Israel. And what I saw there when I was taken to the south, this is days after what happened. And the world did not yet know what happened. I went to a place called Kfar Aza, one of the places that was hit very, very hard. And I see the pictures as I speak to you. We went from house to house. Each house had been destroyed, burned down. Colonel in the army described to us precisely what happened in each house. What happened to little babies who were burned alive? What happened to women? This is before a lot of it even came out and was in the media. And believe me, whatever has been out there, it's not even the complete story. It's more horrible than anything you can imagine. And I remember one particular house I was taken into. You know what I remember as I walked into that house? I mean, this is strange. The refrigerator was open. And all the food was decaying and running. I remember that picture. And he told us what happened in this particular home. He took us to the back. Two sisters were raped in front of their mother and father, who had their hands tied behind their back. And then the father and the mother were shot in the head. And it's even worse than that, because you've heard the stories of the brutalization, the barbarism, the behavior that is not human. Human beings do not behave in this fashion. The horrors that were committed against men, women, and children, in particular, women who were brutalized, young people, 1,200 people, almost all of them civilians. It didn't matter how old you were. Irrelevant. You could have been 80, 85. You could have been 5, 4, 2, 1. Irrelevant. You are a Jew. And you deserve death. I mean, there was one guy who videoed it and called his father and mother back in Gaza. Do you remember that story? The pride this murderer had, calling his father and mother, saying, "I just murdered 10 Jews. And being a good father," he said, "the mother, I remember saying, 'Be careful. Come back safely after murdering 10 innocent people.'" The horrors that were committed that day against innocent people. By the way, the people who lived in the South, in these different areas like State Road, etc., these were the leftists of Israel. These were the people who supported a two-state solution. These were the people who brought Palestinians from Gaza to Israeli hospitals because they cared. God bless them. They cared. What a lesson. At the end of the day, it didn't matter if you were left, right, center. As long as you were a Jew, you deserved to be mutilated. And the world, for a little while, you know, dead Jews play well for a while. You get sympathy for a while. A couple of days, maybe a week, 2 weeks. But all of that has changed. Ladies and gentlemen, Israel was attacked in the most barbaric way imaginable. If everyone would close their eyes and say, if it was 1,200 Americans, civilians, who went through the exact same type of massacre, brutalization, if it was 1,200 French citizens or British citizens or citizens of any other country in the world, would it be the responsibility of that government to do whatever needs to be done to eradicate those responsible, in this case, eradicating this Nazi organization called Hamas?
Yes.
There's no question about it. Any country in the world would do what it needs to do. And yes, there are civilians who have, you know, been killed when Israel went into Gaza and Israel being in Gaza. But ladies and gentlemen, I understand we need to blame someone for that. And the world has gone crazy. Absolutely insane. Instead of blaming those responsible, for months now, all of us, we have watched the battles unfold. Hospitals in Gaza, every single hospital in Gaza is used by Hamas. They have underground facilities. They keep all kinds of weapons in the hospital. Can you imagine your local hospital here? Grenades, machine guns, bombs, you name it, everything in the world. Every single hospital, without exception, used as a terror base by Hamas. Mosques, schools, the civilian population. So ladies and gentlemen, I ask you, what in God's name is Israel supposed to do? What are they supposed to do? You can't attack, you can't do that. What are you talking about? Israel, I can tell you right now, will eradicate Hamas in the coming weeks. And ladies and gentlemen, one of the saddest chapters unfolding in front of our eyes. It's a sad reality. This is not about politics for me. I understand very clearly, you gotta be blind not to get it. That Republicans all over America, elected officials, the people of America who are Republicans, every poll, even the latest polls that just came out today, are overwhelmingly the great supporters of the Jewish people and the state of Israel. That is a fact of life. That is a fact of life. And we are watching. This is sad. You know, my mother went to Auschwitz, went taken in a cattle car with her mother, father, brothers, sisters, nephews, nieces in 1944. And her family, almost without exception, the day they arrived, went straight to the gas chambers. Didn't take long. Straight. You got off. I don't want to go through all the things that happened. Undressed completely. And straight to the gas chambers. The crime they committed was that they were Jews, period. Nothing else mattered. To watch today the betrayal of the one democracy in the Middle East. There's no question about that. There's only one democracy. There's only one country in the Middle East where people, whatever your background is, whoever you are, it is a freaking democracy. That we are watching in front of our own eyes the betrayal of Biden, of the people of the state of Israel. That's what we're watching right now. We're watching members of Congress. It's not just that Trump must win the presidency. There's no choice. There is no choice. And by the way, you know, I'm going to be out there doing everything in the world. And I will say to people out there, look, you may have your issue with Trump. You may not like a particular phrase or comment. That's fine. But there is no choice but to vote for Donald Trump. If you care about America, it's not just about Israel. Look what's going on in this country. It's insanity. Insanity. The issues of immigration, what's going on with crime, everything that matters for our survival, our well-being, is being destroyed by the Democratic Party. That's exactly the case. I mean, you have Democrats, the chutzpah, the audacity. You have Democrats accusing the state of Israel of genocide? What the hell? You know what genocide is? Israel is defending itself, and the civilian population is right there in your face. Can you imagine if all the members of Congress who care so much about the civilians, can you imagine if they all got together and addressed themselves to Hamas instead of the people of Israel? Can you imagine the difference that would make, how important that would be? It is insane. I think we all understand that what the Biden administration is doing, and by the way, or people like Chuck Schumer and others, let me tell you about Schumer. Let me tell you about Schumer. I know him well. There's not an ounce of truth in what he did. It isn't like he really believes it. It was done for purely political reasons on behalf of Biden. It was coordinated with Biden. What a betrayer, for God's sake. What a betrayer. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. So ladies and gentlemen, to be in this room with you, from the moment I walked through the doors, the warmness that you extended, I could feel your heart when I walked in here, how strong you felt about these issues. And here's the perfect thing, by the way. You don't have to be Jewish to love the people of Israel and the Jewish people. In fact, sometimes the guys on the other side are even better. Yeah. Yeah, it's some of my own people who are the biggest detriment and the most dangerous people for the well-being of the Jewish people. How's that? Okay, starting with Schumer and others. They betray us. They have no values. It's about politics. For God's sake, you're playing with the well-being of Israel. This is not some local issue, whether you go this way or that way, okay, fine. You are playing with the lives of the people of Israel. This is real, ladies and gentlemen. I've been there 3 or 4 times in the last number of months. And let me tell you something. The people of Israel are strong. And all, you know, the administration, what a bunch of frauds. What a bunch of frauds. They want to make it about Netanyahu. Oh, Netanyahu, he's the obstacle. He's the problem. That's not true. Look at all the polling in Israel. And the administration knows this as well. It has nothing to do with Netanyahu. The people, yeah, there are people in Israel who want to make change. Fine, the time will come for that. Fine, after the war. But the people of Israel are united that Hamas must be destroyed. All the people of Israel are united on that. It has nothing to do. They've made Netanyahu the boogeyman. Schumer, the rest of them. It's so pathetic and sick and sad. It really is to watch this unfold. You got one little country called Israel. Right? Take a look tonight again on the map. You can hardly find the country surrounded by all of its neighbors. Little place surrounded from all sides. And by the way, remember about Hamas. I mean, by the way, let me tell you who rejoices at the policies of the Biden administration. Let me tell you who has the biggest slack.
Squad.
Hamas. They are rejoicing at the fact that the Biden administration is pressuring Israel. And that they can possibly wait it out. That's exactly what's going on. So let me tell you, you know, my mother, I'm sort of happy she's not here. I mean, she passed away in 95 after going through what she went through. But for her to witness the betrayals that we see would break her heart. Because nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. And for all of us, for each and every one of you, God bless you, really. My coming here tonight, I want to tell you, has given me strength. Because I'm out there in the streets. As you know, I recently got arrested outside of Amnesty International. Because for those who are not familiar, this organization that has 20 million members, we checked their website. They have nothing about October 7th and the women. Nothing. They care about women all over the world. They care about humanity all over the world, except if they happen to be Jewish. So we went to Amnesty International to give them an award for their moral hypocrisy. Three monkeys. I don't know if you saw those three monkeys. Speak no evil, see no evil, hear no evil. And we went to their building on 43rd Street to deliver this gift to them that they well deserve for their silence. And I got arrested. And by the way, you haven't seen anything yet. Because I will be out there doing what needs to be done, period. By the way, I mean, look at our enemies, everybody. Look at our enemies, the supporters of Hamas. By the way, people who want to demonstrate for Palestine. You have every right to do that. We live in America. This is the greatest country. Let's get this clear. This is the greatest country on the face of the earth. Period. End of the story. By the way, do you know any other country in the world that everybody wants to get into? By the way, is there a rush to get into Russia? Is there a rush to get into China? Is there a rush to get into Iran? Everybody wants to go to Iran. or any other country in the world. It is only this country that everybody in every single country wants to get into.
And they are.
Because and you have people in Michigan, you saw the videos, I'm sure, the last day or two. The videos out of Michigan. You have this guy leading a chant in America. Death to America. Death to Israel. Can you believe this in America? And this guy is describing to the audience that this is the worst country in the world. And you know what the irony is? All these people who are out in the streets, the pro-Hamas supporters, do you think they could demonstrate in the same fashion in Lebanon or Egypt or Jordan or any other country? You know what they would do? Or Iran, for that matter. Iran, they'd be shot. They'd be eradicated, right? Only in America can you go into the streets, disrupt people's lives, disrupt the airport. You know, I don't know if you know, Vicky, there's a threat right now for Monday in New York and New Jersey from some of these radical Islamist groups. And it's just a shame that no one is investigating who is funding these organizations. They've got all the money in the world. They are so freaking organized, right? They're so freaking organized. Every day, every afternoon, every morning, they're doing things, they're out there. I'm sort of jealous. We need to do more. So ladies and gentlemen, I just want to share with you, because media talks a lot about Israel losing support in the United States. So let me share with you his final words. And you know, it doesn't matter. Israel wants the support of America. Israel appreciates America and the American people. I know better than most the incredible support that Israel has, especially in the Christian community all over the United States. Israel has no better friends than Christians in America. Yeah. As I said before, sadly, I wish, yeah, it's absolutely a fact. So they talk about all these polls, you know, Israel's losing support. Let me give you the very latest one from none other than Harvard University, along with Harvard University poll, along with Harris, latest poll. American people, you're gonna love this. It should give you strength, because the other side is making all the noise. We're not making that much noise, except for people like Vicky. Some of your fellow members of the council who are Jewish, where the hell are they? And you know it. And you know who I'm talking about. Where the hell are they? Why do we need them in office, for God's sake? If they're not going to be there now for the Jewish people, what the hell do you need them for? Listen to this. Latest poll. 79% of the American people support Israel. Six? Is that something? 79%. And listen to this, 66% in this poll believe that Israel is trying to minimize casualties in Gaza, which they are, but no one talks about this, and so on and so forth. And when it comes to Republicans, just to share with you, of this poll, 72% of Republicans believe that Hamas must be eradicated. And by the way, even 56% of Democrats. So the support is out there. So ladies and gentlemen, we need to dedicate ourselves, everybody in their own way, in every single community. Local races are important. What's happened in the United States Congress on the Democratic side, things are out of control in the city council. Things were out of control in the New York State Assembly and State Senate. It's very different from when I left about 4 or 5 years ago. I mean, it has become so radicalized. That's why we can't get policies to deal with crime that is out of control in this state, in this city, out of control. Because the do-gooders, they're more interested in the criminal. They have Rahmanis on the criminal. What about the innocent victims? What about the store owners? What about the people being assaulted? Why does someone have to be arrested 20 times, 30 times, 40 times, and just walk the streets immediately? Out of control. So 2024, if we don't get some real change, starting with the presidency, we got to make sure that the United States Congress stays in the hands of the Republicans. And if, God forbid, that doesn't happen, God forbid, guess who's going to be running the show in the United States House of Representatives? AOC, Tlaib, Omar, Cori Bush. This is not exaggeration. If they win the House, God forbid, they will be running the show. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. I want to thank you for the therapy for me. Okay? And God bless each and every one of you. Each and every one of you. And you are so lucky. You are so lucky to have Vicky Paladino as a leader that works for you. God bless her. Everybody here, let's hear it for Vicky. Everybody, get up. Come on. For Vicky Paladino. A real, real leader. A real, real leader.